Hello dudes, welcome to techtut.com. In this video, we are going to learn about switch case statement. So we already have learned about if-else for condition checking, right? So now we will learn about switch case. So in switch case, we can only do a particular type of condition checking, which is equality checking of only integer expressions with some constant values. Okay, so remember these 3 points. First of all, only you can check for equality. Second, integer expressions. Thirdly, you can only check the equality with constant values. Okay. So, what will be the syntax of switch case? So, first we will write switch, and within a pair of parentheses, we will write the integer expression. Okay. So, you don't need to give this tag sign, right? You just need to replace this whole thing with the particular integer expression we want to find the equality of. Okay, so then within a pair of braces, we need to write the different cases. So first case, here we need to write some constant value, maybe constant 1, then a colon sign. After that, you write a set of statements which will be executed if this integer expression is equal to this constant value. Okay, so second, if you need to check some other equality with some other constant value, you write that here, and then set of statements for that. Okay, like that you can write as many cases as you want. After all the cases you have evaluated, finally you need to write a default statement. So default is, it's not you need to write, you can write it or you may not write it, but the default statement is, if none of these values are satisfied, then the control will come to this default, and under this default the statements will be executed. So after the default, you close the braces of your switch case. Okay, so revise one switch, then within a pair of parentheses you write your integer expression, then in a pair of braces, you write your cases with constant values, and finally you write your default statement. Okay, so let's take an example. Like you are doing switch, maybe a is an integer. Okay, then if you want to check for values, maybe constant value 3. Okay, so you write 3, then colon. So whenever a's values is 3, then the control will come to this case, and maybe you write printf within case 3. Okay, next there may be some other case like case 22. Okay, and you write printf within case 22. Now these values which you are write as constants, this need not be in increasing order or anything like that. Okay, so you can write it as maybe some other smaller value, maybe 7, printf within case 7. Okay, finally you write your default. Default. Okay, so what will happen when we run the program? If the given value of a is maybe 22, the control will come here. This 3, it is not equal to 3. So it is equal to 22. If A is equal to 22, the control will come here. And what it will do, it will execute this statement and all the other statements after it. So what will be printed? It will be printed within case 22, within case 7, and within in default. Okay. So whenever it is satisfied, if any one of the condition is satisfied, all other conditions after it will be executed. Okay. So what we need to do is, after execution of each statement, particular statement in a particular case block, we need to write break. So what this break will do, it will evaluate this statement and then the control will break from here to the end of switch. So the control will come to the end of switch, so none of the other statements will be executed. So for all the cases you need to write break. But for default you don't need to write break, because after default the statement control actually ends here. So you don't need to write break in default. Otherwise you need to write break. Okay. So this is a fall through behavior. Sometimes it is even useful for some particular programs. I will give examples of this in illustration maybe. Okay. So this is all about switch case. So this same thing we can do with if else, right? So why do you need switch case? I will discuss in another video. Okay, so see you later then. Thank you for watching.